It's me, Tina, and welcome to my channel, Real Talk with Resell Royalty 74. So glad you joined today. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe because you might want to come back and hear more reseller content. I am a part-time reseller and I sell on Poshmark, Mercari, eBay, Etsy, and ThredUp. And I love to just share my information, just hopefully send some encouragement to other resellers. So many other resellers have shared their content. It's been so helpful for me. So that's my only wish, that something I share today will be helpful for you. And today we are going to discuss unclaimedbaggage.com. So I have a box here that I ordered, and I ordered a mystery bag. This is my first time ordering from them. I saw somebody on, I think, Instagram, one of the social media places, do a post about it. They did an unboxing and I was like, never heard of this company. I need to check out their website. So I went and looked around. Didn't have a whole lot I wanted, but they did have a short dress mystery bag for women and it was only $15. If I can get a cheap mystery box or a cheap mystery bag, I'll give it a try. And if I don't like it, I never have to order again. But this was a size medium. That's all they had was a medium. And this is how it arrived. Now, okay, it came in a box, actually. A whole box. We had a little orange unclaimed baggage wrapping paper in there. But this is the actual mystery box or mystery bag. I'm going to show you what I got in there. $15, not bad. I can't remember what the shipping was. And I don't have an invoice, so I can't tell you. But I don't think it was that much. So, okay. So this is what comes in that, right? are you like, what? Yeah. So it's a strappy little pink dress with the cutout. I mean, somebody might like to wear this, look all sexy. It's clearly a bodycon dress. The label is missing. So I don't know what the label is. Oh, okay. Here it is. Well, it's got the material tag. So that's great. It does have a material tag. It's definitely made in China and it says pink size small, which is bizarre because this is a medium box. Okay. So anyway, at least I know the size. It's clearly unbranded. I'll put it up there because, hey, somebody might want to go out and feel themselves, you know, feel sexy. Go for it, hon. I'm not going to judge you. I won't wear it, but you can. So anyway, that's the first item. Here's the second. This is size 8, divided by H&M. Not a bad brand at all. It's a cute little sundress. I mean, that's like super small, though. That's got to be like a tunic, because size 8 is not that small. I mean, that's like, maybe it is. That's super mini. I don't even know. I'm going to have to look it up, check out my Google lens, see what I can find, because I guess it's a really mini sundress, but it's cute. Got the little daisies. It's cute. Not bad. Okay. So if I'm lucky, I can sell that for, you know, $10, $12 and almost pay for this little mystery bag. So that'd be great. This is a If You Be My Star, I'll Be Your Sky. I don't know about that. Size medium. Never heard of this before. I'll have to show you the label because I don't even know. If you can see that. Bizarro. I've never heard of this. It's a sheath dress. As you can see, it's like a plum sleeveless. Oh, that's a problem. Looks like the sleeves were cut by somebody. So yeah, that is an issue. I just noticed that. Yeah, they were definitely cut and sell. So I will be donating that one to Goodwill. I'm really picky about what I'll sell online because I wouldn't want that. If someone said, hey, sleeveless sheath dress, and it's clear that the sleeves were cut, nah, I wouldn't be happy. So I won't sell something to somebody else that I would not be happy with. Okay, next one. Let's see. Oh, this does not look good. It says another made in China. Just got the little tiny M. That's always a bad sign. It's an orange little strappy sundress. Someone might want it for a couple bucks. The material is so incredibly cheap, though. I've got to tell you, I know I'm going to just donate it because it's just not quality. So that's going to Goodwill. And the last item in the mystery dress bag is this. So it's, oh, this is a good item, Zara Basic, size medium. It's a strapless dress. It's super cute. Zara sells really well for me. I know some resellers say, oh, I will not pick up Zara, but I do, and it sells well and it gets attention. So this is a cute little, you know, zipper in the back, spring wildflower dress. That's gorgeous. I like that. So there were two dresses that I'm going to keep, you know, in the $15 bag. So that basically equates to at least $750 a piece for those two dresses, which I'm sure I can get $750 for each dress, but that doesn't leave me a whole lot of room for profit. I wouldn't spend $750 on a dress if I were thrifting, and especially not those two brands. They're a lower end mall brand. So I will tell you, I would pass on this next time. I would not buy this particular mystery bag again. They have all kinds though. They have like wallets, sunglasses, plushed animals, you name it. So you should totally check out their website. I just wouldn't get that particular item again. And then I also ordered on their website while I was there shopping around. They have different items for sale. Like they have some high-end luxury items that to me are too expensive if you're going to resell. But there are some things you can see that are just like happen to be on sale or on clearance. And one item I saw caught my eye. It was new with tags. It's a size 28, the Alley Skinny Ankle. And this is Elaine Bryant. It's pants. Let's see. Anyway, here they are. Yeah, Elaine Bryant. So they're cropped pants. They're large, cute, nice spring color. They got your cropped ankle. So it's perfect. It's kind of like a capri. It's perfect for the spring, but y'all know I love to pick up plus size clothing. I think these are super cute and they're comfy. They feel comfy. They look comfy. So the fact that they're new with tags and Lane Bryant is great. I paid $7 for those pants. So I kind of paid up, but they are new with tags. So, I mean, if I were going to go do retail arbitrage at Marshall's or something like that, I would be excited to find a pair of Lane Bryant new with tags pants for $7. So I would pick them up because I know there's a lot of room. People know they're going to pay up for Lane Bryant. And I think those will do really well. So yeah, that's what I got. Love to know what you think. Like I said, I won't be buying that particular mystery bag again, but I have been back on the website already, just searching their sales section, seeing if there's any name brand items that I think I should pick up. So that is it. Let me know in the comment section what you think about it. And if it's something you would ever want to do is shop on this website, or have you shop there, and what was your experience? Until then, I hope your week is wonderful and I hope your sales are plentiful. Take care, guys.